With 9 million dog owners in Britain today, many of them are battling to be top dog at home.
Look, you can't go behind me.
But one man believes there's no such thing as a naughty dog.
I'm not going near it.
Just struggling owners.
Fonzie, enough!
You think you've got a problem now, and you have. You're really not in control.
And that's when master dog trainer Graeme Hall steps in to take on the nation's dog owners.
I've worked with almost every breed of dog and all kinds of dog behaviour problems, but 9 times out of 10, it's the owners that need to change their behaviour. And that is a really tough message to get across. The problem I got with you is, what you're not doing is any sort of correction at all.
With 12 years' experience, Graham's been put to the test thousands of times.
Come on, let's run.
And the results speak for themselves.
No.
Well done, baby!
Well done!
Honestly, it'll change my life.
It's the start of a busy week for Graeme Hall. In his canine casebook this week, Frank and Ralph, two pugs whose explosive relationship could end in tragedy.
I really think if this carries on, one of them's going to kill the other one.
In Northumberland, Buckley, a miserable lab,
go on, you can do this. Good boy.
Whose owners have a tough decision to make.
Buckley!
Rehoming Buckley, it breaks my heart to think about doing it, but he's in distress, he's not happy.
Graham's first port of call is Lancaster, where he's meeting a lady who recently bought her dream dog, a Great Dane pup called Roxy.
She was so cute coming, and I thought, this is going to be amazing. She's going to be the best dog. 40 years waiting for a Great Dane, and then I get Roxy, the faulty one. That's what I call her, she's the faulty one. My shoes, she's torn to pieces. My slippers, my dressing gown.
Roxy!
My bedclothes, anything she can get her teeth into. She bit my backside.
At 7 months old, this monster pup has a lot to learn about social boundaries.
I can't even go for a bath because she follows me everywhere, so I can't get away from her.
What are you doing? Oi! No, look, you can't go behind me.
Oh. I've tried shouting. I've tried raising my voice. I've even tried talking like a man.
We're nearly there.
She's 7.5 stone now at 7 months. So I'm reckoning she's going to be about 10, 11 stone by the time she's fully grown. She's Godzilla. And I can't take her anywhere.
At home, Roxy is a real handful. But out and about, she behaves like a teenage hooligan. And it's not just Jess, Gail's other dog, who suffers.
No. Roxy, no! Roxy!
She just lunges at the bikes, so her whole body goes towards them. I read somewhere, and it made me laugh, because it said, you know, if your dog's pulling, pick your puppy up and walk with it. And I thought, well, how am I going to do that?
You've got to be Houdini walking these dogs. Right, enough. No, no. See, now look.
Roxy's known in the village for just winding every dog
Roxy,
up.
Roxy, stop it.
Oi, madam, take it in.
Roxy, leave. Come on.
Roxy's lack of social skills often lands her in hot water.
Yeah. Oh, see, it's like you might be fluffy and cute, but I'm big.
Roxy!
But her roadside antics are starting to put everyone at risk.
I worry with Roxy that she's really strong now, and I've had to let go of her twice with the lead, and that was in the road.
Oh, don't run! Roxy!
And I thought, it's either me on my face holding on to her, or if a car had been coming on the other side, she could have caused an accident, she could have been killed, somebody else could have been hurt. It's getting dangerous. I just need some control.
Come on, then.
Taking on a Great Dane puppy is a really serious proposition because they're famously big and powerful dogs. I mean, they were bred to hunt boar. Now, all right, as a puppy, they're cute and adorable and fun-loving, but you really need to be in control of those dogs as they grow up. Hello, Gail.
Oh, I'm glad to see
you. Oh, good girl. Very good. Hello, you. So, tell me about the problems you've been having with her then.
Where do I start? She does everything puppies do. Eats everything, destroys everything.
Yeah.
I used to walk her every day for an hour and a half. I can't walk her at all now. Oh. She's got no sense of who don't like her and who does. I'm just like always saying, sorry, she's a puppy.
I need to see her outside, don't I? So we should go and see that, eh? Let's have a look, see what she does.
Come here. Come here.
As soon as they set off, Gail's lack of control...
He's an old boy as well.
I know, he's got naughty.
And Roxy's boundary issues become apparent.
And she's a little one here as well.
Oh, I see.
See who's out, who she can wind up. Oh. Have a look. Whoa. Seriously, Roxy?
I think we're about to say hello, whether we want to or not.
Sorry.
Hello. Well, it's ended well.
Yeah.
But if that was a dog that wasn't very friendly...
Like that,
we'd be in trouble.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's quite interesting. So is she not normally like that?
No, never.
No.
Never.
I think it is the size thing, to be honest.
Yeah, that's not like it.
What were you thinking when you saw us barreling towards you there?
At first it seemed all right, and then when you get closer, you're like, wow, it's a big dog.
Yeah.
Roxy looks quite big already at 7 months old. In her head, she's just a baby, and she doesn't understand how the world works, what the rules are. Now, it's Gail's job to teach her those rules, and she's not doing it. Come on, you. That's it. There we go. Careful.
See, she's just all over the place.
Yeah, she
she's
is.
Walk in one straight line. Roxy, come. Come on, the road. Roxy! Never actually taken her on a main road, I don't.
Oi! Is that normal?
Yeah.
Is that what she does?
Normally I don't have her, but that was right too close.
She's getting so strong and big.
Yeah, yeah.
She's just diving for
the... Right, she's seen her. She nearly had that cyclist off his bike. Quite apart from the fact it dragged her completely into the road. So if the cyclist had been followed by a car, we could have been in big trouble. Frankly, this is a disaster waiting to happen.
Coming up, can Graeme teach Gail how to control Roxy before this monster pup gets any bigger?
Straight away, you've got your arm up in the air. You're all ready for the fight. Right. As soon as you tense up, she tenses up. And then off you go.
And in Devon, Graeme takes on a pair of pugs whose explosive relationship has become a ticking time bomb. Today, Graeme's taking on Roxy, a big puppy with a big problem.
What are you doing?
Having never been properly socialised, Roxy's lack of boundaries is starting to put everyone at risk, including mum, Gail. But before Graeme can tackle Roxy's reckless behaviour on the road, Gail needs to gain control at home. And where better to start than when mum tries to make her morning cuppa?
What I've seen already, really, is that she doesn't think you're mum in charge. She thinks you're a plaything.
Within seconds, Roxy is sinking her teeth into Gail's dressing gown. And Graeme spotted part of the problem.
And the first thing I need you to do is not to move around, Gail, right? Best you can.
Yeah.
Because the more she's pulling you around, the more you just become like a toy. It's just good fun. Stand your ground, give her the look, go no, and physically, if you have to, move her off. There you go, right, come on, tell her.
No.
That's it.
No. Roxy, no.
So move her away, that's it.
But Roxy isn't taking any notice of Gail, and Graeme thinks he knows why.
When you say Roxy, your voice is going a bit Roxy. That sounds like you're not sure of yourself. It's almost like, Roxy, please, God, you know.
Yeah, it's probably how I'm feeling.
Right, don't let that show. You need to make it sound, Roxy, no.
Right.
Or even better, just no will do.
Right.
Know. So don't move, stand your ground and move her off with your hand.
No.
No. That's it. And again. No.
No.
And again. Keep going.
No.
Now, here's the thing. That took three times going, no, 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 right?
Yeah.
You've got to keep going until she goes, do you know what? Mum's more persistent than me.
Yeah.
Right, go on and tell her. Don't mess about.
No.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Just calmly, calmly, though. Slow your hand down.
Well done.
So last time it took three no's.
Yeah.
This time one no,
one
and she
no.
went, all right, Mum. What's beginning to change is her mindset.
It's a simple technique, but a vital one. Gail will need to repeat the no command and move Roxy aside dozens of times until the boundaries are clear.
So now you've got some control. This is just the beginning, but she's learning that actually there are rules around here with Mum. So what we need to do another time is tackle the problem outside. Well, I think Gail's beginning to make great headway now, and that's good, but we've got a much bigger problem, because if she can't keep control of Roxy outside, then she's going to put herself at danger, she's going to put other people at danger, and Roxy.
Graham's next port of call is Devon, where he's going to visit two ticking time bombs, Frank and Ralph, who both pack an explosive punch.
Come here.
When these pugilistic pugs explode, there's no stopping them.
1 minute they'll be loving each other, kissing.
Am I talking to Ralphie?
Oh, yeah.
You love your brother.
The next minute, they'll be fighting.
Oi, oi.
It's Frank whose fuse always blows first.
I can see it coming because Frank, his face changes. Then the growling starts. And then it just...
It's done.
They've got a love-hate relationship.
And walks are a major pressure point.
As soon as I get the leads out and the harnesses, all hell breaks loose.
They're fighting before you leave the door. It's just horrendous.
Stop.
It's getting worse.
Will now goes to great lengths to keep these scrappers apart before they are walked.
This is the only way I can stop them fighting, just to keep them separate while I'm putting the harnesses on. Every single day when I come home from work, I've got to do this.
But things still kick off once they're both outside.
I do struggle to keep the dogs separate. Frank seems to get more annoyed and more annoyed.
That's enough. I'm doing this for their benefit, but they don't seem to be giving anything back to me.
We dread taking them out. It's a nightmare.
That... No.
But it's 10-year-old Ralph who's having the hardest time of all. Originally Sharon's grandfather's dog, Ralph was taken in when he passed away.
There has been a point where Ralph has actually started to choke as they've been fighting, and Ralph's been flat on his back.
While trying to defend himself, Ralph received a devastating blow.
He's caught him in the eye in one of their fights, and now he's blind in both eyes.
Ralph's always the one that comes off worse.
Yeah, it's very frightening. Yeah, very frightening. Worst case scenario would be death to one of them.
Pugs are usually great with people around the home, but I've seen them being aggressive when they're nervous as well, so not sure what's going on here, and I need to find out. Hello.
Hiya.
Graeme, hi.
Hi, William.
Nice to meet
you.
Please
come in.
Thank you very much. Well, this is interesting because I thought I was coming to see two dogs that were warring all the time. But in the house, they seem okay.
They're okay at times. For no reason, Frank will just lunge at Ralph.
Okay, so the pattern is that Frank starts it, but Ralph's not going to back down. No. I heard that Ralph got blinded, is that right?
Yeah. So they think he might have sight here.
Okay. But,
and then the other eye was detached retina.
Twice he's had Ralph on the floor outside and Ralph swallowed his tongue.
Yeah, yeah.
Where he was starting to go all blue.
How does it feel when they're trying to kill each other?
It's awful. You just want to go out, have a nice walk, but you just can't. It's horrendous. It really is.
Well, do you know what? I think I need to see what happens. So, is your face, your face changed?
Okay, yeah. Ralphie!
While the dogs have been a picture of harmony since Graeme arrived, as soon as it's walk time, everything changes.
No!
Mm. So Will's taken Ralph out. What, just to keep him away? What's the idea?
Just keep him from fighting.
So he now starts to kick off. So the plan then is...
Harness on Ralph out there.
Yeah.
He gets shut in the out bit.
Stay there. Stay. No.
He always jumps on the settee. That's his routine. Harness on.
Come on. Stop. No. Go on. Go.
Well, that looks like a fight, doesn't it? So you've just trapped him in the door there?
Yeah,
you?
It's Leeds trapped in the door.
I need to see this. Right, let's have a look. Right. Well, do you know what? I've worked with 5,000 dogs. I don't think I've ever seen that. OK, what happens next, then?
Now I'll go and get Ralph.
Right. Meanwhile, he's whining and crying. Yeah, he is getting distressed, you're right. He's kind of on his own and he's blind, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, now he's winding himself up. Right, here we go, then.
Once out of the house, there's no let up.
Is this what it's like all the time then, Will?
Every single night,
yeah.
This is how they're going to behave every
time. How does this make you feel?
Well, it's a hot day today, so I'm sweating a bit and I'm getting a bit stressed out.
Yeah, I can tell. We're not overstating the case to say that one of these dogs, sooner or later, could end up dead. Somebody needs to be in charge.
We do.
We've
lost control.
Yes.
We do feel we lost control.
To put it bluntly, you've been making it worse. It's like a play that they've seen so many times. They're acting their part. This is the bit where I bark. This is the bit where I bite. This is the bit where I try and bite him. And then it just goes mad as soon as you get out the door. I think we need to break it down and just take charge of this situation.
Okay, good.
These two dogs are physically hurting each other. And I really think if this carries on, one of them's going to kill the other one. Now I've seen it, I can't walk away.
So Will. Coming up.
Hey, same with him.
No.
Will Graeme be able to get these clashing canines to declare a permanent truce?
No.
And can Graeme help Buckley overcome his crippling fear of shiny floors?
I've got to turn around 5 years of phobia. Can I do it? Well, I don't know.
Okay, come on.
I just keep kind of going over and over again thinking, what did I do wrong?
In Devon, master dog trainer Graeme Hall is taking on two pugs, who for the last 3 years have spontaneously burst into attack mode.
No!
And it's walk time when they're at their worst. Graeme fears if he doesn't stop this now, feisty Frank could kill aging Ralph.
What happens here is like a play that's been choreographed by Will. Everything happens exactly the same way. So a harness comes out, that's when it gets scary. Ralph goes out. The harness is put on Frankie. Then Frankie's trapped in the door. He brings Ralph out.
Come on.
And then when the door opens, it's all hell let loose. It's one heck of a rigmarole. We need to take all of the excitement out of it. The harness is the thing.
It's the thing
that
sets
them off. Mm. Yeah, the trigger. So I've got some harnesses behind me. if a new harness doesn't have an effect on them, then we're on a winner, aren't we?
Yes.
But if they react badly when the harnesses come out, it's really important that we nip it in the bud. Firm no, so it's all down to your voice, right? But if they don't react, then we need to praise them for being good boys.
Right, okay.
Yes, okay.
Simple, in theory.
But with Frank always flying off the handle as soon as the harness appears, they'll need to be ready to jump in.
So, there we go. Now, he's seen them. Now, which way is he going to go? He's either going to go, oh, doesn't matter, or he's going to start getting funny. There you go. Good boy. How about that?
Good boy.
Not reacting is rewarded with some praise.
Great reaction from you. Well done.
I can't believe it, to be honest.
Yeah.
It's like a different dog. Who's
never that
my
calm
Frank?
With harnesses before.
No. Never.
As soon as he sees a harness, that's when he starts to get wound up.
Yeah. We've just upped the ante a bit, so what's going on with that? Let him have a little sniff of it and check it out, and that's fine.
Good boy.
The look on your face is a picture with. I mean, they're so calm, they're actually falling asleep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Time for the next step, putting feisty Frank's harness on. But will this four-legged ticking time bomb stay calm when the harness actually goes on?
Now the harness is going on, I can see he's got a bit more excited. Let's see what happens.
He's yawning.
He's yawning, which sometimes is a stressy thing.
Good
he's licking his lips, that's similar.
Good boy.
That's it. And then give him a bit of slack. That's it. I'd still hold on to it, but not tightly. There you go.
Good boy.
Good boy. Well, that was pretty much a non-event, I thought.
Well, you're calling it a non-event. I'm surprised how calm he was, because I've never put a harness on Frank and him being so calm.
Right.
I literally can't believe it.
So far, so good.
Well, there's only one last stage to do, isn't it? How do you feel about going for a walk?
Yeah, let's go.
Right. Grace.
No.
But when both dogs have paws on the floor, ready to be walked, the temperature rises.
No.
And the dogs continue to goad each other.
Hey, no.
Despite repeatedly being told to stop.
No.
No.
Meaning Graeme has to step in to take charge.
There. Now we're getting somewhere. Let him sit down again with you. Good boy.
Calm restored.
This time, let's just try and get through the door and see what happens. Off you go, Will.
Go.
But having suffered a setback, Graeme wants the dogs to be walked separately at first, by Sharon and Will.
Come on, good boy.
Come on, Murphy. Come on.
Step, step. Good boy.
Good boy, that's
no.
Super.
Good boy.
Right, let's go for a walk.
Come on, then.
That's it.
Good boy.
The couple will need to give their pugs praise when they're good.
That's a good boy.
Hey, this is better.
Oh, this is heaven.
Yeah.
And nip any bad behaviour in the bud.
No. That's it. And move again.
No. Good boy.
Right.
No.
Crisis averted. And for the first time in months...
Good boy.
They're walking down the path doing nothing. Nothing is really good.
Come on. Come on. Quick. Come on.
Great.
Right.
You just walked your dogs down the street and there was no problem.
Oh, no, amazing.
Amazing.
Amazing. Yeah. Can't believe it.
80% improvement, yeah, definitely.
Right, I think that's an honest assessment. Good. There's one more hard thing to do, and that's this morning. Well, when you were walking the two dogs on your own, it was a disaster, really.
It was,
yeah.
I think we can do it now. Are you up for it?
Yeah, definitely.
Right, come on, let's give it a go then. Right, give him a dog.
Good luck.
That's it.
Thank you.
That's it.
Oh, yes.
Oh, great. He actually looks...
He's enjoying it.
He does?
Yeah. Relaxed Will.
You're right, actually.
Yeah.
What was once a hellish chore for Will is now pure pleasure.
How's that feel?
Feels fantastic.
Yeah.
It really does, yes. Two calm dogs.
I didn't think you'd do it, to be honest, honestly.
Good. I think you've done really well, and we've come a long way today.
Yes.
So, yeah, certainly, yeah.
Put it there.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you, Graeme.
All the best. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Take care of yourself.
Thank you. Take care.
Bye-bye now. The situation at the start of the day couldn't have been worse. There was a high likelihood that one of these dogs was going to be killed. Sharon and Will really need to keep this up, because If they don't, they'll be back to square one.
Really pleased, aren't we? Really pleased. Exhausted, really pleased, but really pleased and like really positive.
To see some results at the end of one day, it's amazing.
Makes you quite excited to carry it on tomorrow.
Next, Graeme's heading north to help the Brett family, whose lovable Labrador Buckley has developed a rather unusual phobia.
Come on, Bucks.
Any hard, shiny surface, laminate wood, tiles, he simply won't walk across.
Come on. Come on.
The couple got Buckley 5 years ago, after purchasing their first house together.
The house felt a little bit empty. We weren't ready to just start a family quite yet, so getting a dog was the natural progression.
2 years later, Mastiff Ted joined the household, followed by the couple's first child, Freddie, completing the family.
Morning, Ted.
Morning, Ted.
Morning, Ted.
But it's Buckley.
And Buckley.
Yes.
Whose strange fear of floors...
Come on, you can do it.
...sees him a prisoner in the utility room.
Come on.
The only surface he'll walk on.
He doesn't want to come out in the living room or all these other places where he could happily interact kind of with Freddie and with his family.
He's so nervous all the time, and that feeling must be awful for him. I feel like he's regressing a little bit as well. He's retreating and spending less time with us.
As Buckley's floor phobia got worse, Glenn came up with an idea, peppering carpet islands across the ground floor.
We realised if we put a blanket down, he would walk on it. And I think in our heads, we just thought it was a temporary thing.
It can't keep going that way in the future, especially with a toddler and would like to have more children. The time it's taken to deal with Buckley's issues is becoming a real problem.
Kind of rehoming Buckley, it breaks my heart to think about doing it, but it does keep popping up in the back of my mind. I don't want to do it, but then I think you can see he's in distress, he's not happy. You know, am I being kind of selfish keeping him almost? Because I don't want him to go.
Buckley's fear of shiny floors is really unusual. Now, I have seen it before, but it's probably one in 1,000 cases.
A bit of barking going off. I guess that's Buckley, isn't it?
Hello, hiya.
Hello,
family.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Hello.
You're not a Labrador.
Right, so this is Buckley then, eh?
Yeah.
Bless him. Buckley, come here then. Come here. He looks really sad. Let me go and say hello.
Buckley.
Oh, bless you. So how old is he then?
Buckley's 5 now, yeah?
Yeah, 5.
He'll be 6 in October.
Oh, nearly 6?
Yeah, 6, yeah.
And when did this start then?
We didn't notice it until he was coming up to about 1 year old.
So you're putting down bits of carpet and runners to get him from A to B.
Yeah.
Is that the only way you can get him around then?
That's the only way we've found, I think.
And that's combined with coaxing.
Yeah. I just keep kind of going over and over again thinking, what did I do wrong?
Uh-huh.
You know, or what didn't I do? Or was I too tough over this or too soft over that?
So you feel guilty because you almost feel like you've been a bad parent.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I think I need to see it.
Right, Foxy, are you ready?
There you go, mate. That's it.
Come on. Go on. That's it. Go on. Good boy. Come on, Foxy. Come on. Go on, that's it. Good boy.
Go on, you can do it. Good boy.
Despite the carpet islands only being a few steps apart, it's far enough to stop Buckley in his tracks.
Go on, good boy. That's it. Good boy.
I've never been able to get him to kind of go, like, round a corner without there being a carpet halfway around that corner.
So what have we got? We've got a really quite extreme case of a dog who's scared of something that, you know, to you or I might appear a bit random, but it's very real to Buckley. And I've got to turn around 5 years of phobia and get him to be happier walking across all surfaces. Can I do it? Well, I don't know until I start the training.
I don't think your carpet islands thing was a bad idea at all, because we can use them as stepping stones.
Yeah.
And then as we go, perhaps space them apart, or maybe take one away.
But before tackling his floor phobia, first Graeme needs to rebuild Buckley's confidence.
I just want to go for a walk with him, so he gets used to me. We build up a little bit of a bond. I want to build his trust up first, and we play follow my leader. Come on, you.
To develop Buckley's confidence, Graeme's turning lead training into a fun game. If Buckley follows the leader and mimics his pace,
he's walking.
He's rewarded with praise.
Good boy. Yay, come on.
It's amazing.
There's a little bit of trust coming in.
Yeah.
He's more than just complying, you know. He's actually enjoying the game. You know, he's like, oh, go fast, go slow. Yeah.
But will Buckley follow the leader indoors?
Look at that, that's lovely. It's a change of mindset. All you've got to do is just keep walking with me. We'll have a nice time. How does that translate to inside? Well, it's obvious, isn't it? We're going to walk into the kitchen and go, let's walk through together.
Yeah.
Come on, then. Lovely. Come on, then. Oh, not so sure there, were you? That's it. Come on, then. Good boy. Good
with lad, Graeme giving Buckley good no boy. Option of backing out,
let's go back.
This Labrador is soon following in his footsteps.
Good lad. That's very good. He's getting it. But he's still nervous. He's like, OK, I'll trust you, but I'm not sure yet.
Yeah,
I'm not
yeah.
feeling it.
The only way for Buckley to overcome his phobia is to repeat the process dozens of times.
Oh, lovely. I'm going to do something quite bold now. I'm going to take all of the carpet islands away.
I'm still not sure.
If you start to say to yourself, it's not going to work, it's not going to work, it leaks out to the dog.
He'll sense that.
He will. Yeah. I don't even know how they do what they do. If you walk through and go, I'm just seeing this in my mind's eye, it's going to be fine. There you go. Keep going. Keep moving. Keep moving. That's it. Well done. We had a bit of a moment there. But...
Good boy. Good boy.
So the big problem is the hallway bit.
Yeah.
Buckley's made it to the living room, but he's lost his footing and Danielle's confidence has taken a knock.
Come on back through, Danielle. Keep moving.
With Danielle losing her nerve, is Buckley starting to panic?
Okay.
Yeah, come on back through when you're ready. Just go.
Graeme.
Oh, you're struggling.
Yeah, from the rug.
Hello, mate. You all right?
Graeme steps in.
Come on.
And confidently gets Buckley moving again.
Hey. So we stopped on the scary bit. I'm going to turn around. Come on. So this is just like in the park. If I go, I go.
Yeah.
I stop. Good boy. So if you get a problem, once you got him moving, try and keep going if you can.
It was awful just seeing him panicking a little bit.
Yeah.
And he has obviously got better.
When he has a little panic attack like that, it's really important that we don't look the same. So even though you're thinking, oh, bless him, the look from me is like, yeah, I know, mate. Come on, you've got a job to do, I'll show you. Mm-hmm. We'll do it together. Mm-hmm. So if I keep moving, he starts to get the hang of it. That's fine. Look at that. Just go. Keep moving.
Good boy. Come on.
Marvellous. How's that feel?
Amazing.
Well done. Good boy.
Although I'm trying to pretend he'll just do it. Yeah. I still really thought he wouldn't.
Yeah.
But seeing you do it a few times, I think I was a little bit more confident that he would.
Good.
But there's one last hurdle for Buckley to overcome. He's never walked from the kitchen to the living room by himself. To sweeten the deal, Graham's leaving treats at the finishing line.
Oi, hey, what's through there? Maybe take one step forward and then just send him.
Buckley, off you go.
That's it. Tiny little skitter on the floor. Fantastic.
Amazing. I can't believe he's done it. I just never thought you would do that.
Congratulations, you've got a normal dog.
Just gobsmacked. Almost speechless, to be honest. I can't believe how well he's done. And each time you see his confidence getting more and more and more.
Amazing. I'm on a high. I'm quite speechless, really. I just didn't think he would do it. I'm so proud of him.
All in all, we've come an awful long way in the time I've been here. I can hardly believe it myself. And it makes me really happy.
Graeme may have helped Buckley conquer his fears, but in Lancaster, he still has a monster pup
whose terrifying roadside antics need to be tamed. Graham's back in Lancaster to complete his final challenge of the week, helping Gail with a Great Dane who's got major boundary issues. The problem is, seven-month-old Roxy has never been properly socialised.
Stop it!
On his last visit, Graham showed Gail how to set boundaries at home.
Stand your ground, give her the look, go no, and physically, if you have to, move her off.
Roxy, no.
So move her away, that's it.
This morning, he's got a much tougher task, teaching Roxy rules outside the house before someone gets seriously hurt.
Outside, it's, well, frankly, downright dangerous.
If Roxy's going to be taught about social boundaries, first, Gail needs to be able to control her monster pup on the lead.
If she starts to pull, you don't hang around. You've got a split second before you're off your feet. What you're aiming for is that, relax, is flick and release.
Come on.
She's beginning to go, look, flicker. That's it. And again, there you go. That's it. Yeah, good girl. In slow motion, I can see she's starting to go. In a minute, she'll be off.
Yeah.
And if you miss that, you're sunk. So you've got to go, oi, don't even think it. And the flick's quite fast, so it's like bang, bang, on, off.
Right.
Right. Come this way, I've got somebody I want you to meet.
Getting Roxy to remain calm where there are no distractions is one thing, but controlling this Great Dane around dogs or cyclists is a much bigger challenge.
So let's talk about socialisation. It's about getting her used to lots of things that she's going to come across in life, but there are some rules attached. And I think up to now, it's perhaps been a free-for-all where she's just bounded up and done whatever she wants. So this is meeting, but with rules.
Graham's organised for Roxy to meet with a young cockapoo called Alfie. To succeed, Gail will need to make sure Roxy approaches Alfie calmly, something she's never managed to achieve before.
Straight away, you've got your arm up in the air, you're all ready for the fight.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I want you to relax.
Yeah.
And I want to see that slack then. Be ready, but don't tense up. Right. As soon as you tense up, she tenses up. And then off you go. That's it. That's it.
But as they approach, Roxy's excitement starts to build.
That's it. Good girl. She's beginning to go. Look, flicker. That's it. And again, there you go. And then say hello.
Girl.
That's it. Hello. Yeah, that's fine. No, you'd have to hold her back. It's fine.
Right.
And she's going in to sniff. That's fine. I don't mind if they're sniffing each other's bums. When you're ready, I would just call her name and go, right, come on, we're off.
Come on, Roxy. Come on.
Just go. That's it.
Good girl.
Good.
For once, this hyperactive pup hasn't pounced on an unsuspecting pooch.
Well, that's your first little experience. How did that feel?
Yeah, really good.
What's the difference?
Normally it's 100 miles an hour with her.
Yeah.
She just, no patience. She's got to get there instant.
By slowing things down and using a flick of the lead, we're able to keep Roxy's excitement level really low. But cyclists are a different kettle of fish because we can't ask them to slow her down. So getting Roxy not to lunge at them is going to be a hell of a lot harder.
Thanks for helping.
You know, there's nothing complicated. It's get the voice right, get the movement right. In your case, moving through her if you have to, you know. But the right mindset is the most important thing. It's like, no, young lady, you are not going to push me around. We're going that way.
Yeah.
Losing control of Roxy and causing an accident has become Gail's greatest fear.
No. Okay, Chris.
Will she have the confidence to hold on?
Good girl.
So she's seen him. Keep walking.
Good girl.
Don't sound desperate.
Good girl.
Walk in front of her. That's it. Now, your voice went, no. But your body language was right. It's like, oi, where are you going? Yeah? Good. That was all right. But do you know what? Let's do it again, because I think we can do better. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, good girl. That's super. Keep walking. That's it. Brilliant.
No,
flicker.
This time, with a clear command and body block, Gail's got her Great Dane under control.
Well done. Great control.
For the first time ever, Roxy is starting to respond to Mum's rules.
Now that is a lady in control of a dog.
Yeah.
even with the bike barreling downhill towards them. Great.
I felt it as well.
Great. Okay. Yeah. I do have one last challenge for you. Because you've done really well. Kind of got an obstacle course, the like of which you'll never ever see in the real world. Step this way. Come on, power up, it'll be fine.
But of course, Graham's not going to make life easy. He's keen to socialise Roxy with everything she might come across on a walk with Mum.
So, it's pretty obvious what I want you to do. Say hello nicely to the dogs. When we get to the horse, we're clearly going to walk past. And if you hadn't noticed him, Chris on his bike up on the hill, he's going to come cycling past. We've got to keep control of that. And if you manage all that, I can go home.
OK.
Listen, I wouldn't risk it if I didn't think you could do it. You've got this.
OK.
Off you go. First dog.
Say hello.
Lovely. Say hello.
Stay.
Stay.
That's it. Lovely. That's fine.
Stay.
Little bit with Bumble.
Roxy, no.
That's it. Get control. Well done. That's it. Relax your arm. You're fine. Lovely. Straight past the horse with a bit of look. Wants to play with the spaniels, look, bless her. Cyclist. Yeah, it's just a non-event. Oh, no, maybe not, look.
No.
Just at the last minute. Oh, I want to play. But the difference now is she still had that thought. Gail just took control of it. And it was over.
Well done, Roxy. Well
Fantastic.
Done.
Fantastic, well done. So, never met a horse in her life. Fine with a horse. So much better with the bike.
Yeah.
And the dog, she's meeting him in a nice way.
Proud of you, Rox.
She's growing up.
Yep.
Only a few days ago, Roxy couldn't be walked without risking a major accident. Now this giant pup is finally becoming the dog Gail always wanted.
You know, there's still a lot of work to do with her, and she's still young, but yeah, she's done amazing today. I'm really proud of her.
Working with puppies is so satisfying because I've always said that what I do is about making people and dogs happier together. And when you start with a puppy, you're setting them up for the rest of their lives.
In Exeter, Frank and Ralph are finally walking happily together. Having got over his floor phobia, Buckley is enjoying time with the family. And Roxy's training has been going so well, Gail's bought her the ultimate reward. Meet Presley. Next time, a bulldog whose hunger knows no bounds.
My God!
The stakes are high with two German shepherds running wild.
Stop.
And a boxer with no respect for the woman of the house.
No. Kitchen.